So the first question I have to ask, because you have a new haircut.
I do.
Do we get to a scene where maybe you try and cut the hair, or do we get an explanation about how you cut
Sadly,
your hair?
Sadly, we don't, but I do know how it happens.
Oh, how does it happen?
Because this is how Clark Kent also shaves. She laser beams into a mirror, which reflects back and cuts it. And that's how he shaves his stubble, apparently.
Yep.
Okay.
That's what I've been told.
I'm really glad you're the answer for that.
So, a few times now, you've been able to address Supergirl's motto on the show.
Right.
And I've got it right here.
That's awesome.
So, how does getting that motto out into the world feel to you? Because it's a very new motto, but it's very good for her.
I think it's the most important aspect of our show and our responsibility to do so, and I think that is part of the reason that we went so topical last season and really addressed it. I think our show is always stronger when we lean into politics a little more, because it is so ingrained, I think, in Superman and Supergirl's identities.
What about directing?
I'm very excited. I'm really looking forward to it. We have such a great group of casting crew and producers, and I feel very supported and a little bit terrified, and I'm happy it's happening.
Melissa's actually been quietly making some music videos on set.
Have you seen that?
Yes, yeah, that's I think that's where you got the job.
That was my pitch?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
I'd love to get a sense of where you feel Kara as a character left off at the end of season 4,
yeah,
and sort of what the journey is for season 5, not for spoilers, but as a person, how she's evolved.
I'm just always concerned because I'm so fortunate in my character arc that I get to do so much on this show. I'm never really wishing that I could do something as a character, so I'm always just concerned that she keeps evolving as a woman. We keep exploring femininity and what it means to be a woman in today's world, and how women interact with each other and their relationships, and just across the board too, how she interacts with everyone and empowerment. So as long as that is a trajectory that's growing up and forward, I'm happy.
And your opinion of the new costume?
I love it. I love it. I was very happy with the skirt for a long time, but
I think when we moved to Vancouver, I think the skirt became slightly less practical in the winter months.
Yes.
But I think also one of the things that's so great about the show is we've really watched Kara grow up. I don't think growing up is something that only happens when you're a kid. I think it continues to happen your whole life. And so it feels symbolically like a nice, as she's standing in her power.
Mm-hmm.
Pants are more comfortable.
Yes.
Can you tease something about the first episode? What the first expect from episode 1?
We just wrapped it. What can we tease?
I mean, I think that something we can tease, it's not a huge spoiler, but really central is Lena's reaction to the reveal of who Kara is. And that betrayal, which is really justified and fair for her to have, but what she's going to do with it, I think is going to be very intense for everyone.
Yeah.
Have you guys noticed any changes in schedule now that Crisis is coming? Because you've got to film 9 or 8 episodes, and then there's this movie you have to film.
Yes.
Is there any changes this season because of how big?
Every season there is. It is a... first, there's the kind of Jenga of all these showrunners getting together and breaking the story, and then there is all of our incredible crews, all of our line producers, production managers, like ADs figuring out how to do this, because it is the most complicated scheduling nightmare you can imagine.
Yeah.
But what's good is like every year it's gotten bigger because we learn from what we've done and we kind of learn how to do it better. And I don't even remember if we shut down the other shows the first year. It was really insane. So we're learning every time.